Thank you very much. Thank you also the organizers for organizing this very useful debate. I was asked to talk about public service media staffing. Well, after the presentations and after what I hear about stopping public service media in March or on April, if there will be no public service media, there will be no staff for sure. And I hope really that that your policymakers, your society, the whole Ukraine would not allow that Ukraine would become the first country in Europe without public service broadcasting. For sure, as Audrey has mentioned, if you are aspiring membership in the European Union, this would not help in this way towards the European Union. This is part, public service broadcasting is a democratic institution. It is part of overall reforms. Your government several times said that this is a cornerstone of the reforms in Ukraine, and it is indeed connected with rule of law, with building institutions, with respect of rule of law, and also public service media should be allowed to exercise its genuine role of a watchdog of the wrongdoings of everyone in power. There were before continuing with my presentation, there were several questions of what is public service broadcasting. And me, myself, I'm Bulgarian. I actually started my career when we were just transforming from state media to public service media. And I'm very sensitive about this question because I believe that this is a very revolutionary change which we have experienced. And it is, for me, it is very clear because state broadcasting is established by the state. It is governed by the state. It is controlled by the state. It is paid by the state. The editorial policy is controlled by the state. It is responsible to the state and is serving the state. And if you just replace the state with the society, then you would understand what is the concept of public service media. Because it is established by the people, it is governed by representatives of this civil society, it is controlled by them, it is financed by the people. The editorial policy and the purpose of public service is to serve the people, and it's of course responsible. Boris mentioned, and Audrey is also about the accountability and transparency. If it is using public money, then it is of course responsible. I'll give you one example to even better illustrate. Everyone would maybe remember Chernobyl in 1986. At that point, Bulgaria, we were having a state television. So people were not warned that something so dangerous happened and that they should not be exposed to outside, to water, to special products, etc. Well, public service media should exactly do the opposite, inform the citizen and serve the citizen and warn them in such national disasters. So now I would continue with the presentation. Could you please put the first slide? Okay. So there was a lot of talk already about the public service remit, what exactly public service should do. And in all EBU membership, I don't think that I need to introduce EBU to you, European Broadcasting Union, because you have won the Eurovision Song Contest, you hosted the Eurovision Song Contest, but our organization does many more things than the Eurovision Song Contest, and we embrace 73 members from 56 countries. All our members more or less have similar remits. And this is to inform, to entertain, and to educate all segments of society. This is a very broad remit, which requires programs for different segments of the society. It requires children programs, it requires programs for minorities, it requires programs for people with disabilities, it requires programs really for everyone in the society. And such a broad remit, of course, very naturally requires adequate, sustainable, predictable, and independent funding. However, nowadays, public service media are facing many challenges. And there is a big pressure on public service media to effectively and efficiently use the funds which are allocated to them. The challenges which public service media face range this really from starting from economic pressure and austerity measures of various governments throughout Europe, to severe competition, to fast technological developments, disruptive innovations, and fragmented audiences. Boris touched upon a little bit on the differences between how much is the revenue of the public service media and the competitors. We have to really acknowledge that public service media is, so to say, changing engine while flying, because while fighting all these challenges, competitions, integrated vertical and horizontal competitors, it also has to transform and to become a genuine service to the citizen. This is just a table which illustrates the big difference for the revenues of public service media against the major clusters, four clusters of competitors. All 64 EBU public service media earn 35.8 billion euro. While the top 10 European commercial broadcasters, Liberty Global, Sky, RTL, Canal+, ProSieben, Sat.1, ITV, Polsat, TF1, Mediaset, LTG, earn 62.66 billion euro, which is almost two times the whole revenue of the whole 74 public service media in Europe. Then we go to the other cluster for competition. These are the top five U.S. media conglomerates: Comcast, Walt Disney, Time Warner, 21st Century Fox, Viacom. Five times more they earn than all 64 public service media, and their revenue is 185.37 billion. And then we move to the third cluster, which are the European telecom operators. They earn seven times the revenues of all public service media. And these are, you know, all of them, Deutsche Telekom, Vodafone, Telefonica, Origin, British Telecom. And then the most dangerous ones, the top five internet and tech giants, Apple, Amazon, Alphabet, Google, Facebook, and Netflix, earn 12 times the revenues of public service media. So in such severe competitive environment, we really have to make sure that public service media, which serve the democratization process, which serve the whole society, has to have an adequate funding. Public service media facing all this challenging throughout Europe is trying to accommodate this economic pressure and austerity measures and pressure from competition, obviously, in developing strategies how to more effectively and more efficiently use the budgets which are allocated to them. So the strategies, of course, reflect these economic situations, and there is in all public service media strategies, recent strategies, there is a lot deliberation and consideration about restructuring, reorganization, cut of staff unavoidably, and of course, Ukraine is not an exemption. This is an illustration which I took from our members' strategies. So you have Ireland, which just signed their strategy from 2018 to 2022. They are planning almost 70% cut of staff. Then in Finland, there is one-third cut of production. In Denmark in 2017, there was a cut of 60 jobs. In France, for this year, there is possible cut of 1,000 jobs. In Portugal, there was a cut of 52 jobs in 2016. In Switzerland, 250 job cuts and pay freeze at SRG SSR in 2016. In Belgium, BRT cut 220 jobs in 2016. In Austria, they are also embarking on a cost-saving program of 300 million euro until 2021. 50 jobs were already cut in 2017, and up to 300 jobs are expected to be cut until 2021. So of course, how this the cut of staff would have inevitable impact on the programs of public service media, we have to take this into account. These are some figures about the average staff in Europe. There are 422 PSM employees per million inhabitants. You could see this also on the if we could see it on the next slide. Could you please put the next slide? Okay. So the next slide shows like the dark blue shows over 600 employees per million. Then the light blue is between 400 and 600 employees. The yellow is between 200 and 400 employees. The red is below 200 employees per million. Yeah, there are great disparities in staff costs across Europe. The average is 440,000 staff costs per fixed term employed staff in Europe. This figure represents the relative weight of staff costs in the of the PSM operating revenues. Of course, if you are interested, I could explore more and show you how are the figures of our competitors, especially these 10 European biggest private companies. It's much lower, but we have also to keep in mind that they do not produce that much programs and that much valuable content as public service media produces. This is very indicative. I think that maybe Zuraf would have a much more correct number, because this was based on only the staff in Kyiv. I think that the regional centers are not reflected, but in any way this very well indicates that the Ukrainian public service media is absolutely underfunded. These are the correlation between staff and programming expenditures by country. And you could see that, of course, when you cut staff, it would have an inevitable negative effect on the programming. So I think that I would not go. There are many other more slides which are illustrating the correlation between staff and correlation. What I would like to draw your attention is that the working force in Europe. It's not the last one, but that doesn't matter. The working force in public service media definitely is shrinking. 59% of the EU public service media operations operated with fewer staff in 2015 than they had in 2012. And of course, this is due to the austerity measures and increasing pressure from competitors. Public service media organizations have been experiencing repeated funding cuts. In 2015, almost 40% of the public service media organizations were operating with decreased financial resources compared to 2011. Public service media organizations such as BBC in the UK, RTVE in Spain, and BRT in Belgium have introduced cost saving plans. I have illustrated also in the other slides many more examples of broadcasters which are considering in their strategies how to basically function with limited resources. In the medium term, a reduced workforce, of course, might affect the capacity of public service media to produce attractive content. Just maybe a comparison with other creative industries, the personal cost in the manufacturing industry often is set between 15 and 13, but out of the operating expenditures, but they can grow up to 50% in service related sectors from where we are at the public service media is. Comparison with the private broadcasters show that our expenditures are higher, but again, we have to take into account that these private broadcasters do not produce that many programs as us. I would stop here because I think that we are advancing with the time. I would be glad to answer any questions or provide even more detailed data. But I really hope that we would come to this point once you settle the most pertinent now question, the overall funding and sustainability of public service media in Ukraine, which seems to be a very urgent and a very important matter for the democratization of Ukraine and joining the European Union. So thank you very much for your attention, and we'll be happy to discuss further.